Good morning, everybody. Oh, come back to that again. I can. Welcome to our daily thought for Wednesday. I'm actually on time today. Well, 2 minutes late, but for me, that's pretty good. So I hope you're tuning in. We are really near the end of Acts, aren't we? So I'm reading in Acts chapter 25 today, and there's only 28 chapters. So I'm going to be reading to you from Acts chapter 25, verse 13 to 22. In my Bible, it's headed Festus Consults King Agrippa. So I am predicting some interesting biblical name pronunciations. Apologies in advance. A few days later, King Agrippa and Bernice arrived at Caesarea to pay their respects to Festus. Since they were spending many days there, Festus discussed Paul's case with the king. He said, There is a man here whom Felix left as a prisoner. When I went to Jerusalem, the chief priests and the elders of the Jews brought charges against him and asked that he be condemned. I told them that it is not the Roman custom to hand over anyone before they have faced their accusers and have had an opportunity to defend themselves against the charges. When they came here with me, I did not delay the case, but convened the court the next day and ordered the man to be brought in. When his accusers got up to speak, they did not charge him with any of the crimes I had expected. Instead, they had some points of dispute with him about their own religion and about a dead man named Jesus who Paul claimed was alive. I was at a loss of how to investigate such matters, so I asked if he would be willing to go to Jerusalem and stand trial there on these charges. But when Paul made his appeal to be held over for the emperor's decision, I ordered him held until I could send him to Caesar. Then Agrippa said to Festus, I would like to hear this man myself. He replied, tomorrow you will hear him. So this is really interesting. I think it's a really good example of how people sometimes miss the point of the resurrection and miss the point of Jesus. And I read this really interesting history story. I know I'm not here for history story, so I'm going to tell it really quickly. But it's about the Wright brothers. And the Wright brothers, if you don't know, were the first people to like invent aeroplanes and to fly. And they'd been trying to create aeroplanes for a while, trying to fly, and eventually they managed this flight. And I think it lasts 59 seconds, but it was really exciting. And so they're so excited that they send a telegram to their sister, and it basically says something like, sustained flight for 59 seconds, full stop, should be home by Christmas, full stop, because telegrams are short like that. And the sister is so excited that she runs to the newspaper, and she says to, she communicates with the editor of the newspaper and says, the 59 second flight and they'll be here by Christmas, shows them the telegram, and the next day the headline of the newspaper says local bicycle fixers home by Christmas. And basically the editor had completely missed the point of the telegram. You know, the point was they'd managed to fly, but he'd picked up on the bit where they were going to Christmas. And I feel like that's what's happened to Festus. So if we look in verse 18, he says, when his accusers got up to speak, they did not charge him with any of the crimes I had expected. He basically thinks that what Paul's talking about is no big deal. Then verse 9, he's like, oh, some Jesus guy, because he just doesn't get who Jesus is. And then he even talks about somewhere in verse 19, instead they had some points of dispute with him about their own religion. He feels like it's a private matter. And I kind of think that's what a lot of people feel like about Christianity today, about the resurrection today. They think it's no big deal. It's just a private matter. This Jesus guy, he wasn't unique. He was just some crazy person. And you know, it's not worth arguing. Festus is kind of like, I don't know why they bothered bringing it to me. Can they not sort it out themselves? It's no big deal. And I think lots of people, especially in our culture today, where it's kind of okay for everyone to have their own little view, they kind of look at us as Christians and they think, oh, that's nice for you, but it doesn't impact me. And I think sometimes we perpetuate that because we do operate on our own and we kind of maybe are a bit afraid to put the headline out there that Jesus rose from the dead. And I think back to Easter, and you know, Easter, oh dear, I hope that hasn't paused the video. Easter is a really magical time, isn't it, for kids with Easter eggs and all of that stuff. And you know, it was lockdown last Easter, and so we did an Easter egg hunt in our garden, and the boys were finding all the eggs, and I'm posting all these pictures on Facebook, and everyone's liking them, and that's lovely. But what headline was I selling last Easter? Chocolate eggs and cute children? Or Jesus Christ, alive, and offering salvation. You know, I think that should really challenge us. You know, the world thinks it's no big deal. And is that because we're making it not a big deal? I think we need to make it a bigger deal. What's your headline? I don't know. I don't think mine's big enough. I think I'm still talking about the Wright brothers coming home for Christmas and forgetting that they actually flew. So make sure your headline is all about Jesus. I think lockdown has reminded us, if nothing else, to think about what's important, and what is important is the resurrection and its salvation. Let's not be Festus. Let's not be that editor back in the 1940s when the Wright brothers were there. Let's make sure that we are showing people how much of a big deal Jesus really is.